PTDF has announced, as can be verified from the online portal, that applicants for 2020 scholarship for master's and PhD degree must have a national identity card number before applying for the scholarship. That applicants are also expected to verify their name before starting the application. Concern that name precondition for the scholarship is now a major stumbling block to otherwise eligible applicants who are yet to obtain their name. Worried that most Nigerians are yet to obtain the name due to no fault of theirs, and therefore it will be unconscionable to visit the scenes of the National Identity Card Management Commission on innocent Nigerians or applicants, as this is a failure on the part of government. Cognizant that the registration process of NIM is indeed very laborious and slow nationwide due to the inadequate facilities and manpower, that the DG of the NIM, Mr. Aliyu Aziz, has recently admitted in the National Daily that they are overwhelmed with the work because, whereas they need about 4,000 centers at the moment, aware that the Joint Admission and Matriculation Board, JAMB, recently suspended the use of NIMS as requirement for the 2020 UTME due to technical hitches at NIMS. Further worried that the same hitches that greeted JAMB over the NIMS are likely to compromise the PTDF scholarship program for this 2020 if nothing is urgently done to reverse the decision by the management of PTDF. Note further that while it is important to have a national data capture in view of NIMS, especially for purpose of security, it must be done in a manner that it does not impinge on equally very important national exercise like the PTDF scholarship and JAMB. Observe that whereas it doesn't take more than 2 weeks to obtain a social security number in the USA, same feat can be replicated in Nigeria with a proper amount of funding as well as the right deployment of technology. The House hereby resolve, Mr. Speaker, and direct the management of PTDF, indeed all government agencies, to suspend forthwith the requirement of NIN as a precondition to access or enjoy any government program, project or patronage until further notice, to direct all government agencies to provide at least 1 year moratorium for Nigerians who have not obtained NIN to do so. In the interim, other forms of government identity, such as international passport, voter's card, bank verification number, could be used in lieu of NIM, pending when the NIM is finally obtained. Three, that the federal government be urged to properly fund and equip NIM for speedy and efficient nationwide delivery. I beg to move, be toyed with. Nigerians today, we are grappling with unemployment. And when there's any opportunity to provide for our teeming youths extra knowledge, the NIM issue is beginning to be a problem. Not too long ago, the JAMB brought NIM as a precondition, and at the end of the day, it did not work. PTDF is coming up with it again, and I think this is an ugly trend that should not be supported. Because if you go to the United States of America, in less than 2 weeks, you get your social security number. If you are in the UK, in less than 2 weeks, you get your national ID card. And again, we have other forms of ID card, and I believe in America, the biggest form of identity that you can carry around is even your driver's license. You don't need your passport. There are passport offices in Nigeria. There are people who have driver's license. We have voter's card. We have BVN. And all this information and data that they are collecting is a failure on the part of government to put in a central mechanism where this information sharing should work. And that should not be a problem for our youth who does not know anything. The father cannot commit a sin and avenge the same sin on the son who knew nothing about it. And I believe, Mr. Speaker, our youth should be allowed to live their life while we plan adequately. It is a good thing. We understand not too long ago, the United States of America placed a travel and a visa ban on Nigeria because of security and data collection. But if we had to do that, if we had to look at it, we are collecting data. What are we really doing with the data that we've been collecting? We have to, first of all, give our teeming youth the opportunity to rise while we work on all these things. So that is why I brought this motion, so that this thing should not be a precondition for now. We should put a time frame with which The people that have not gotten this name should get it. We agree we have to put on a central information system. We agree that our security should be enhanced. We agree that we should know who we are dealing with. But to stagnate the nation and our growing youth because of name, I think is an aberration that this house should speak against. Because we've always done it as a house that speaks for the masses, and I want us to join our voice in this one to ensure that our children are not deprived because of the failure of government. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. One of the prayers is that the PTDF and other government agencies should henceforth not use that for now as a precondition, that if you don't have NIM, you should not apply for scholarship. You don't have NIM, you cannot write JAMB. You don't have NIM, you cannot write a WAEC. That is one. Then two is to direct government to provide at least 1 year so that people can get more, giving the government time to provide funds and equipment for NIM to actually take us, so that you can go there and get registered, not go in there for a whole day and only 10 persons are registered. And at the end of the day, you're putting as a precondition. Then finally, that the government should make provision for adequate funding and equipment for the office.
Okay.
I want to adopt the submission of the minority leader wholeheartedly. And on the issue of people referring to the United States of America as a model, the social security number is given to a child from birth. And here we are talking about a national identity card that should start from 18. It shows we are not even ready in the first place. Because if you succeed in taking the 18 and above, what happened to the ones that are coming behind? How many of that persons form part of the 180 million Nigerians? That is one. Then two, Mr. Speaker, it is a right. The ID card is a right. The scholarship is a privilege. But when we talk about our commonwealth, I think it's a right for every Nigerian to enjoy our commonwealth and not be different. And again, this so-called national identity card do expire, Mr. Speaker. It expires. I got my old some days ago, and it's already about 6 months to go. What is going to happen if I decide to apply tomorrow for another national requirement? Then again, Mr. Speaker, I think it is good for us to know here that I am not saying that we should suspend the issuance of the national identity card number. What we are saying, like what the minority has said, is that the process should be ongoing, but it should not be a precondition for any Nigerian, for any of our brothers and our sisters to enjoy the commonwealth of our nation. We know that there's a letter we call that emanates from community. We have a local government identification process in Nigeria. If we are fair and we are honest, everybody is from a local government, everybody is from a community. And those communities are part of the requirement that PTDF is asking for. And that should actually help part of it. Then again, Mr. Speaker, we have various types of ID card. What happened to our voters' card? Are you agreeing that it's foreigners that voted for us? What happened to our driver's license? Are you agreeing that without somebody, because for you to obtain a driver's license outside the country, in the church that they are referring to, Mr. Speaker, you must be a legal resident. You can't just come and get a driver's license. You can't do it in England, you can't do it in the US. Today we are practicing the American style of democracy. And that is what it's applicable. So if anybody is having a driver's license in Nigeria, the person is already either naturalized or is a legal resident in Nigeria. So, Mr. Speaker, I am not saying that we should suspend the issuance of the number, but that it should be suspended. It should not be used as a precondition to give services to our people, because that will not be good. It will not be good for Nigeria. We need to grow our people. We just listened to a talk just now from Magnus Marco about developing a human capital development. And this is one of the issues. Our graduates want to go abroad and learn. Yesterday here, my brother from Okpe brought an amendment to the footprint law so that we can start training our people internally. These are things that we should support. I don't see anything there. Mr. Speaker, it's so easy that nobody is stopping the NIM. I'm in agreement to it. But again, let us use other form of identity that we have. Our international passport is still our great passport, proud one for that matter. We have our voters' card. We have our letters from our communities. So we have so many forms of identity card. Why should it be NIMS that is so difficult to get? If you want your passport today, Mr. Speaker, you can get your passport today. If you want a driver's license, that is the one that will take another forever. Only God knows when it will come. Your voter's card, you can get a slip just now. So why don't we use what we have so that our people can enjoy the benefit of a government? Thank you, Mr. Speaker.